No matter what project they're working on, you'll eventually have to connect some wires together.
There are a few different ways to connect small wires. Some require only a bit of duct tape, and you'll need special tools for others. I'll show you 6 different methods, one of which allows you to easily detach the wires in the future. Also, connecting mains cables is done a bit differently, so please only use these tips for low voltage wires. Before you can connect wires together, you have to strip the shielding first. If you are only doing this once or twice a year, any kind of sharp edge will do the job. I actually used this utility knife to strip hundreds of cables, but you do need to be careful and it takes up a lot of time. Here's a great tip right away. Don't be cheap like I was and just buy an automatic wire stripper. It's fast, consistent, and a lot safer to use. Also, having something to hold the wires in place will make your job a lot easier. Actually, anything that can hold a wire will do, like for example 2 empty paper rolls. Simply use a pair of scissors to make a cut and you're good to go. Of course, you can also 3D print a holder like this one. Or you could buy a proper soldering stand. If you have to connect wires in place, then I'd recommend printing this hand holder. This way, you won't have to cut the wires away if you want to solder them together. Okay, so the first method is quick and easy, but I wouldn't use it for anything but a very short-term solution, until you can make a proper connection. Begin by twisting the strands together as tightly as you can. Finish off by applying electrical tape around the twisted part for insulation. A much better way is to actually solder the wires together. Twist the strands as before. Hold them in place. Finish with a bit of solder. You can then use electrical tape as insulation again, or you could buy special heat shrink tubing. Just place it around the splice and use hot air gun over the area. The tube will shrink and insulate the wires, but also hold them together. The next method is a combination of the previous one. You can use tubings like this that are called solder and seal connectors. C simply place it around the splice and heat it up. The solder in the middle should melt and flow over the wires, and the tube should shrink and hold everything in place. It's an easy and effective solution, but the connectors are a bit more expensive. The fourth option is by using Pushin wire connectors like this one. Of course, if you're using stranded or soft wire, you'll have to crimp a connector to one end so that they have something solid to push in. As their name suggests, you simply push in both wires and that's it. This is probably the best option if you have to connect multiple wires at once, as you can buy connectors with more than two slots. If you think you'll need to replace parts in the future, you can't go wrong with the Dupont connector. They are more difficult to assemble, but they allow you to easily disconnect the wires in the future. You will need to buy both male and female connectors, as well as the plastic cases. The housings come with different number of slots, which makes it easy to connect multiple wires at once. Lastly, you also need a special crimping tool that can handle Dupont connectors. Sadly, ordinary crimpers have different dies that usually don't work for Dupont connectors, so you likely need a dedicated crimper. And of course, they're excellent when you're just building a prototype of something. I'm sure you've seen them with any Arduino kit. The fan on my printer is a great example of when you should use Dupont connectors. If it ever fails, I can easily replace it in the future. The final option doesn't even require you to strip the wires. You can use these so-called quick splice connectors. Simply insert the wires on both ends without cutting the insulation and push down the pins. It will cut the wire and create an electrical connection. The downside is that if you want to reuse the connectors on the same wire, you'll have to cut away the damaged ends first. For me personally, I prefer to just solder and use some heat shrink tubing. Or if I think that I'll have to replace something in the future, I tend to use the Dupont connectors. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.